Good day, everyone. We continue on in our daily messages. Today, just really short, I just want to bring a thought to your mind, but those of you who travel and have used these devices, you know, it used to be our things that we'd mount, now it's basically our phones. But anyway, when you are on a course that is not the course you should be taking, you hear those words, or that word, you hear the word recalibrate. And, you know, this might be a time for some of us to recalibrate. To recalibrate means to adjust, amend, change, reshape, revamp, revise. Some of the paths that we were on weren't going the direction that we really wanted our life to go. Some of the activities we were involved in, we need to probably pull out of. And this is a good time to analyze that. You know, we have this space and we have this time. You know, the writer of James brings us to this moment where he says, just really simply in James 1:22, but prove yourselves doers of the word and not merely hearers who delude themselves. So some of us have been listening to the word of God, but we really haven't been carrying it out. And this is a time in the kindness of God where he's bringing some of us to this moment, bringing us to the attention that, you know, you really need to do this. Not just listen to it, not just affirm it in your head, but do it. And some of those things are like, you know, how we treat people around us. You know, maybe before we didn't know our neighbors, and now everyone's out on the street and we're 6 feet apart, yes, but out on the street we can actually say, hi, this is my name. We can extend that friendship that we weren't doing before, so that's really simple. Other paths are really, really maybe life-changing. It may be a relationship that's struggling right now, and God is saying it's time to recalibrate. You can't keep doing what you're doing and expect a different result, right? That's the definition of insanity. If I keep doing what I'm doing, but I expect a different result. To some of us, we need to change what we're doing. Husbands need to treat their wives differently, to show them respect and kindness and love and admiration and the things that they've been craving. And some of the ladies in the room need to give that honor and respect to your husband, the one who provides for your family. Now, some of you kids need to recalibrate how you treat your parents and what you think of them. And some of us just need to recalibrate our relationships. I think in this time of the connections I'm reworking or going back to, maybe some people I haven't talked to for a long time, I have the time now to text message or instant message or send something out to people I haven't talked to in a long time. Recalibrate. Don't keep walking the same path. Remember that the path is going to go where the path is going to go. It's not good intentions that change the path, it's an action. So that's what he's saying in James. He's saying, don't just give a head knowledge to some of this. You have to make action happen. You have to change something. So today's thought I really have for you is, what do you need to recalibrate? What in your life has this, you know, break from normal circumstances, what has this helped you to recalibrate? I won't fill in that blank for you, but I think all of us would do ourselves well right now to think about some change. I think about some things that could be different, that we've heard this, we believe it, and now it's time to put it into action. Today I ask that you would remember in prayer, already we have had lost people, so there are grieving families because of this virus. And they're grieving in an entirely different way. With what we can do and how many people can gather, some people are not able to even be with their loved one when they pass. They don't have the gatherings that we would have had before, the memorials or funeral services. And so I would ask you to remember those people. And it will be more. There will be more people who grieve. And that grieving person needs the touch of God. And so let me lead you. But remember today those who grieve because they've recently lost someone. Not just because of the virus, but they've recently lost someone. Lord, we pray for those who are grieving today and that their grief would be met by your compassion and your love. Give us instruction. If there's someone that we could reach out to and someone that we could love on, help us to do so, God. It is really, really hard to lose someone. It's heartbreaking. And this day it's multiplied as people literally are watching loved ones from a distance pass. That's just hard to even imagine. So God, I just pray that you will be with grieving families, touch them with your love and compassion. In Jesus' name, amen.